Hey guys, welcome back. So in one of our recent videos, we took you guys through our moving process and showed you some ways to find affordable moving companies in Japan. And today, I want to go over the entire moving process from start to finish and when you need to get them done. Let's go. Living in Japan is pretty awesome. There's incredible culture, beautiful nature, and being able to live here has been such a blessing. But when it comes to doing adult things in Japan, that's what you call a nightmare. And moving is one of those. I don't think the moving itself is more complicated than other countries, but everything being in Japanese makes it 10 times harder. It's hard to understand what's going on, keep track of things, and it's just a very big mental stress. Which is why I wanted to provide an English resource for anyone else who might be going through the same thing. Just a small disclaimer, everything I'm about to talk about is for a typical move in Japan. And depending on your situations, some things might change. You might skip a step or you might have other things to take care of as well. I try my best to include everything, but in case I missed anything, please let me know in the comments and I'll update the description accordingly. Also, to go along with this video, I'm also working on a PDF checklist for anyone that likes a tangible reminder. And the download link will be in the description once it's finished. All right, let's get to it. So once you sign the contracts to your new address, the first and most obvious step is to cancel your current lease. Make sure you have a couple of days of overlap from your old and new place so that you have some time to move all your stuff. For our recent move to this house, both our old and new place only allowed lease changes to happen at the end of the month, so we had a whole month to move all of our stuff. Also, a note of warning, most housing contracts in Japan have a minimum length of 1 to 2 years, so if you're moving before that, then you might have to pay a penalty. Alright, so once you've decided when to cancel your contract, the next thing you do is to decide how you're going to move everything. If you're using a moving company or a rental car, you'll want to do this as soon as possible because depending on the season, they might be fully booked or you'll get a better price by doing it early. And if you're looking for affordable moving options, then feel free to check out our previous video, which I'll link up in the info cards. So the next thing on the list is taking care of your internet service. So the timing for this really depends on your situation, but in some cases, you'll need to do this as early as 1 month prior to moving. And the reason for that is because for some homes, it requires construction to get the fiber optic line connected to your home. This was the case for my previous apartment and the one before that. And in order to get that done in time, I'd say you'll need to start taking action about a month in advance. Like I said, this isn't the case for everyone. This tends to be the case for older buildings, so you should check to make sure whether you'll need construction setting up internet at your new place. So one inconvenient thing about living in Japan, if you want to throw away large items, you have to make an appointment and pay for it. Large trash is called sodaigomi in Japanese, and what's really considered large trash really depends on the city or ward that you're living in. But generally, what's considered large trash is basically what doesn't fit in a normal trash bag. And it's also the case for long items and electronics. This would be considered large trash. This would be considered large trash. Even this is large trash. Yeah, you get the point. And many wards take appointments from 2 weeks to 1 month in advance, which is way too early to know what you're going to throw away or not. And I want to go over some alternatives for throwing away your large trash. But if you know for sure that you want to throw away something, on Google you can search sodaigomi and the name of your city, and it'll generally be the first or second result. And some of you might be thinking, why don't I just leave it outside on moving day? I mean, no one's going to really stop you for that, but it's just not good for manners, you know? When in Japan, do as the Japanese do. So there's a couple ways to get rid of your large trash. One way is to sell it at a recycle shop. They won't pay much for it, even if it's good quality. If you're lucky, you'll get about 500 yen, but it's better than paying to get rid of it, right? Another option is to give it away for free or even sell it to another person. You can join one of those buy and sell Facebook groups in Japan, or sell it through Merikari or Rakuma, which is like an online free market app in Japan. Another option is to break it apart and put it in the bag. During our last move, we had some wooden cabinets that we weren't going to use anymore, and we didn't want to pay for large item trash, so I just broke it apart and put it in the bag. And finally, you can set up an appointment with a private trash collection company. This is different from the government one because you don't have to go out, buy stickers, and bring your trash outside. You can make an appointment much closer to your moving date, and they'll actually come and pick it up from your home. But the only thing about a private trash collection company is it's going to be more expensive than the government one. In Japanese, it's called 不用品 回収 業者. Yeah, you can search that on Google. So around a week before moving, you'll want to set up mail forwarding with the post office. It's called 転居 届け, and it's a nice little service that they have. What they do is if they receive any mail for your old address, they'll redirect it to your new address for up to 1 year. So it gives you a little bit of time to update your address in different places like the bank or your Amazon account. You can do this online and it's completely free. The link will be in the description. The next step is to take care of your utilities, water, gas, and electricity. In most cases, you'll be able to do this online, but if not, then you'll have to do it over the phone. And depending on what companies your new and old address uses, you'll have to either switch completely to a new service or just transfer it from your old house to your new place. I believe water is run by the government, so you'll keep the same services if you're moving within the same ward. But electricity and gas are run by private companies in Japan, so it varies depending on your home. I'll leave links to the online transfer form for common services in the description. Also for gas, you'll need to set up an appointment for them to come in person and do a safety check on your new place before you can start using gas. So make sure to arrange that before moving, or you'll end up taking cold showers. One of the final steps before the move is to let your local government know that you'll no longer be living there. You'll have to go to the ward office, which is called 区役所 in Japanese, and fill out what's called a 転出 届け. To find where the nearest ward office is, you can search in Google Maps your city name and 区役所. One thing about this is you can only go during the weekdays, so if you have school or work, then you'll have to take some time off. And you'll need to bring your insurance card and residence card. Congratulations on moving to your new place. Now there's a couple more things to do. So the first thing you should do when you move to a new place is check to make sure everything's working. Electricity, water, and gas. Hopefully you made an appointment with the gas man to do a safety check at your new place. Or get ready for cold showers. In case one of them's not working, it's good to realize this sooner than later. The next thing you need to do is go to the ward office for your new place and let them know that you just moved in. If you're moving within the same ward, you can skip this step. Once you're there, you'll have to fill out a form called the 転入 届け. And once again, you'll need your residence card and your health card. They'll print your new address to the back of your residence card, and you'll have officially moved to your new address. And last but not least, you'll want to update your address everywhere. Some important places include your university or work, your bank account, your phone company, driver's license, Amazon account, and that's it. At this point, you should be extremely proud of yourself. There was a ton of things to do, but you pushed through and you've now successfully moved into a new, beautiful home. I think it's beautiful. Once again, notes and links to different resources are in the description below, and let me know if anything's missing and I'll add it on. And while you're here, don't forget to leave a like if this video provided some value, and also subscribe for more Japan life tips and travel videos. That's it for this video. Happy moving, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.